There's a 10% fee on tanning salons. Since that fee went into place, 45% of the tanning salon businesses have gone under. We've reduced the number of tanning salons by 45%.
Is that part of Obamacare?
Well, the 10% tanning, the fee was, because they were looking to raise some funds, right, to pay for the subsidies and things
that. Are tanning salons good for people's health?
That's
for people to decide.
Right, that's for individuals to decide. 2009, there were 18,000 tanning salons. As of 2014, there are only 10,000. So that's a 45% drop. 65,000 jobs were lost in the process. Most of them were women.
Yeah, are tanning salons good for us? Are they good for health?
Tanning salons are not. And I fought, and we now have a warning on the tanning bed that says that, you know, it's akin to the black box warning on cigarettes. And I have legislation, which I'm happy to get to you, is especially for young girls. They want to have a tan all the time. They're going to a prom. The incidence, it only results in many times in cancer.